Linda, please describe the virtual mammography project.
BARCO is working with the University of Pennsylvania to really fully understand the human breast. And so the University of Pennsylvania has anatomy models, virtual models of the breast, and BARCO brings some technology on human observer models. So together we're hoping to really understand how the human interacts with these images and how technology can change that over time. And I think the real advantage is going to be that we'd be able to do some of these clinical trials in a virtual environment and not always have to rely on the interaction with human patients to really understand and test potential future advances in technology. The funding comes from the U.S. government, from the National Institutes of Health. So we have a grant from them that will cover our work together with the University of Pennsylvania for 5 years.
What will be the benefits in the real world?
In the real world, it'll help us to really understand how technology can help us see more details in the breast and to be able to test some of those technology advances in a virtual clinical environment without having to use actual patients or, you know, humans to do the testing.
What are potential future projects in this area?
I think based on what we find out of this grant, it'll really prove that some of these clinical tests could be done in a virtual environment, exposing people to radiation and some of the things I would have to do to actually do the studies themselves. So I think once we do this on the human breast, there's opportunities to do a similar thing on other parts of the anatomy.